Taiwan as a destination isn't hard to sell. It has a lot to offer to tourists and they're pretty diverse, from its rugged coasts to its lush inland mountains to its vibrant cities. These are all connected by an impressive and efficient railway system, making it so easy to explore. And oh, it's one of the cheapest destinations in East Asia. And if you're planning a trip to Taiwan for the first time, there's no better place to start than its colorful capital, Taipei. Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Yosh. In this video, we'll list down some of the best things to do and places to visit in Taipei. For this batch, we'll be focusing on attractions within the metropolitan area and reserve day trip-worthy sites in our next video. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos. When night market is mentioned, Taiwan is the first place that comes to mind, just because of the sheer number of them on the island. Although the concept of night markets originated in the Tang Dynasty, probably between the 7th and the 10th century, it wasn't until the 1950s, years after the Second World War, when the first night markets were officially set up in Taiwan. Prior to this, small collections of food stalls punctuating the streets already existed, but it wasn't until then that these were recognized as night markets. They initially catered to migrant workers looking for cheap, simple, and easy-to-eat street snacks. Today, Taipei alone has a network of these markets sprawling throughout the city, the largest of which is this, Shilin Night Market. Shilin Night Market is composed of two levels of labyrinths. The ground floor and the adjacent alleys house mostly souvenir item shops, apparel stores, and food stands too. The basement, on the other hand, hosts a maze of stalls offering a wide variety of Taiwanese delicacies and Asian favorites. Some of the most common and most popular here are fried squid, grilled chicken tails, breaded chicken or fried chicken steak, Taiwanese sausages, fried buns, and oyster omelette, among others, served by the food court's almost 540 stalls and eateries. It's so easy to reach because it is only approximately 70 meters away from the metro station. If you have more time, try to also check out Shida Night Market located within the University District and Rauhe Street Night Market, one of the oldest in the city, located in Songshan District. Ximending refers to the area immediately surrounding Ximen Station. It is a popular entertainment, dining, and shopping district. It's also one of the best places to stay in Taipei thanks to its wide array of accommodations, most of which are pocket-friendly. Ximending is bright, energetic, and bustling. Think of it as Taipei's answer to Tokyo's Harajuku. Here, you'll find shops of global brands, bars, cafes, and clubs. One of the most popular attractions here is the Ximen Walker Street, which is always abuzz with tourists and locals alike, many of whom gravitate towards shops and food stalls. Although historically, Taiwan is more associated with tea, coffee has overtaken it as the preferred drink, especially over the past several years. While Taiwan is not a big coffee producer, it is a voracious coffee consumer. Taiwan is reported to have over 15,000 coffee shops, around 25% of which can be found in its capital. This makes Taiwan one of the places with the highest concentration of cafes in the world. It is something that is pretty evident with just one sweep across dining districts like Ximending. Everywhere you look, there is a cafe, and they range from the usual cafe chains to specialty shops. One of the cafes we tried is Fong Da Coffee, which is said to have served the first iced coffee in Taiwan in 1956. While most coffee shops strive to be hip and Instagrammable, Fong Da Coffee takes pride in its vintage look and old-school ways. Another popular drink not to be missed when in Taipei is, of course, bubble tea or pearl milk tea. Taiwan is the world's bubble tea capital. While it is Taichung that is regarded as the birthplace of this immaculate and a bit sinful drink that took the world by storm, Taipei has more than its fair share of milk tea spots. Many of the most globally recognizable milk tea brands like Coco and Share Tea originated and are headquartered in Taiwan. But if you want a really memorable milk tea experience, head over to Modern Toilet, a cafe-resto that has been serving crappy meals and drinks, including milk tea, for years. And by crappy, we mean this. This food spot made waves when it opened, attracting visitors from around the world. Everything here is toilet-themed, from the tables, to the seats, to the decors, to the menu. This ice cream is served on a toilet-style bowl, and their tea cradled in these urine containers. And yes, they serve milk tea too. Taipei 101 is the most iconic landmark of Taiwan today. For 6 years, it was the world's tallest until Dubai's Burj Khalifa opened. The record may have already been broken, but Taipei 101 continues to take visitors to new heights. Standing 509 meters tall, it was the first skyscraper to break the 500 meter mark. One of the tower's many symbolism is its series of 8 sections, each composed of 8 floors. And you might have already guessed that 8 is considered a very lucky number in many Chinese cultures. Located in Xinyi District, Taipei 101 offers a fantastic view of the city, from its indoor and outdoor observatories. It's like a one-of-a-kind tour of the city from the top. From its many viewing sections, many points of interest can be spotted, giving visitors a sneak peek at these sites before they could even set foot in it. Taipei 101 prides itself in not just its height and architecture, but also in its structural design. Taipei lies along the Pacific Ring of Fire and a common route of typhoons. This 728 short-ton damper helps by serving as a pendulum, swaying to counter the tower's movement. It hangs from the 92nd floor and is open for public viewing. While the view from Taipei 101 is breathtaking, there is an even better lookout which offers a view that includes this iconic skyscraper. For that, you have to head to the Elephant Mountain. They say that the best time to trek here is late afternoon, allowing the hiker to reach the top and appreciate the view during the day, at sundown, and at nightfall. Thankfully, there are a lot of resting points along the way. Benches can be found throughout the trail and lookout points dot the path. Don't forget to bring water and a lot of stamina because while it is a relatively easy hike for the physically fit, it can still be pretty challenging for those who don't move a lot. The National Palace Museum is home to roughly 700,000 artifacts that date back centuries, but only a mere 1% of it is displayed in the main museum. The rest is kept in heavily guarded, temperature-controlled vaults in the nearby mountains. It's a collection so vast, almost unimaginable. And it includes 6,000 bronze pieces, 3,000 calligraphy works, and thousands of pieces of gems, carvings, and textiles, among others. The sprawling complex has different exhibits and displays that showcase Chinese culture and history. If you are interested in seeing much of them, you should be prepared to spend hours inside. Built in 1969, the National Revolutionary Martyr Shrine, or simply Martyr Shrine, houses spirit tablets of around 390,000 individuals who lost their lives during the many wars that Taiwan fought. Spanning an area of 5,000 square meters, the site harbors many structures. The main sanctuary is said to have the same architecture as the Hall of Supreme Harmony at the Forbidden City in Beijing. The arcade of the building speaks through paintings of tales about numerous battles. There are also a bell tower and a drum tower within the site which play a role during important ceremonies. But it's not the architecture nor the artifacts that most tourists come here for. Every hour, the straight-faced and almost immovable soldiers guarding the shrine change in a calculated military fashion. Clad in blue uniforms, the guards march from the main sanctuary to the main gate with their bayoneted rifles and switch positions in complete synchronicity. The whole routine takes around 15 minutes, slow and perfect. One of the most popular historic sites in Taipei, this memorial hall was built to commemorate Generalissimo Chiang Kai-shek. A colossal statue in his likeness is housed and displayed in the main chamber of the octagonal and blue roof memorial hall. The main chamber is also where a guard mounting ceremony is held. On the ground level, you'll also find a library and a museum that narrates the life of the honored figure. You can find the memorial hall in Chongcheng District. The Liberty Square, National Concert Hall, and the National Theater are some of the notable attractions within the complex. Another monument built in honor of a great man, this memorial hall pays tribute to Dr. Sun Yat-sen, a statesman, physician, and a leader, often dubbed the father of the nation. The hall has exhibits of Sun Yat-sen's achievements, the perfect place to learn more about him and his place in history. The construction of the hall started in 1965 and finished in the 1970s. The hall is also a venue for exhibitions and performances. This folk religion temple was built in the 1740s and was initially a wooden shrine. As the centuries came and went, the temple went through numerous renovations and reconstructions. Bawan Temple enshrines the god of medicine in Taoism and Chinese folk religion and a saint of the Song Dynasty. It is actually the biggest temple dedicated to the deity in Taiwan. It features a three-hall layout, which is traditional of Chinese temples. The main hall, the rear hall, and the triple gate front hall. On the sides lie the bell tower and the east-west wing. Longshan Temple dates back to the 1730s. It was built by settlers from Fujian, China. Situated in Wanhua District, Longshan has survived for more than a century, even after wars and natural calamities. It is a house of worship for Buddhists and Taoists. In our next video, we'll be taking you to day trip destinations just outside Taipei but are still easily accessible from there. So be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon to get notified when it's up. If you need more information about traveling around Taiwan, you'll find comprehensive travel guides with sample itineraries on our website, www.thepoortraveler.net, or check out the links in the description. If you have questions, make good use of the comment section below. You can also follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @thepoortraveler. You may also tune in to the Poor Traveler podcast on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.